Our project is about the analysis and renewal of EEG-ECG artifacts using the ANN classifiers. The project is presented by myself, Divya LK, Dashni VK and Anita M with the guidance of Mr. S. Lokesh, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, Baltic Engineering College. First, let us look into the overview of the project. The main abstract of our project is to classify the EEG brain signals of patients to distinguish between the normal and the abnormal persons to detect the cardiac problems by the means of artificial neural networks. The test samples of the patients will be classified for the better performance accuracy of the system. The main aim of our project is to remove the artifacts by using the pre-processing method and to monitor the symptoms of cardiac problems by giving the EEG signals as input. This project can be done by using the EEG signals with large data sets. Next, let us look into the block diagram of the project. When carrying out this implementation, there are two sets of functions. The first set of functions are the input EEG signals, pre-processing, stationary wavelet transform, and gray level co-occurrence matrix. The second set of functions are dataset, training process, feature extraction. These both sets of functions are carried out simultaneously, and the second process is also called as the ident process, which can be done automatically. The results of these two sets of functions will be combined in the neural networks to classify the results as normal or abnormal. Now let us look into the description of each blocks in the block diagram, where the first block is the input EEG signals. The input EEG signals is given in the form of EEG signals of peak values with respect to the amplitude and time period, where data are stored in the Excel sheet, that values are given as input to MATLAB software, and the further process is carried out. Next process is the pre-processing method. The input EEG signal is then given to the pre-processing method for the removal of artifacts in the given input signal. The further process is the stationary wavelet transform. It is also called as the wavelet transformation algorithm, which is designed to overcome the lack of translation invariance of the discrete wavelet transform. The next process is the gray level co-occurrence matrix. It is also called as the gray tone spatial dependency matrix. The GLCM is a tabulation of how often different combinations of pixel brightness values occur in an image. It is also called as a feature extraction technique. The features can be extracted from the given input EEG signals. The second set of functions includes the data set. The data set is nothing but a set of predefined samples of ECG signals which are stored in the database to compare with EEG signal and to classify the normal and abnormal of a person. The next step is the feature extraction process. The feature extraction process is the process of transforming the input data into a set of features which can very well represent the input data. The main parameters to be considered for the feature extraction are accuracy, predictivity, consistency, and advertisements. Then finally, the results of these two sets will combine to the neural network. A neural network is nothing but an biological neural network, which is made up of the real biological neurons, or an artificial neural network, which are used for solving the artificial intelligence problems. Neural networks are especially well suited to perform the pattern recognition to identify and classify the objects or signals in speech, vision, and control systems. They can also be used for performing the time series prediction and modeling. The project is implemented by using the next process is the artificial neural network. There are so many types of neural networks available. Our project is implemented by using the artificial neural networks. It is also called as the ANN classifiers. An artificial neural network is an interconnected group of nodes similar to the vast network of neurons in a brain. Our project is implemented by using the MATLAB software version 2014A because it is more efficient in analyzing and processing the signals in a proper way, so it will be more easier to observe the signals properly. Now let's proceed to demonstrate the implementation. The first process is to open the MATLAB software and load the code from the source files by browsing and select the file from the left panel on the window. The code is updated successfully. Now run the code, one new window will get opened with functional buttons which is to be processed for the signal processing. In this window, click on the browse button to upload the input signal. It will plot the graph of the signal with respect to the amplitude and the time period. The input signal is updated. The next procedure is the pre-processing method. Next, click on to the pre-processing button. It will equalize the signal and filters the unwanted peaks. The filtered signal is shown in the screen. The next process is now click on to the wavelet transition button. It will convert the frequency domain into the time domain. Now it will extract the subbands of 1 low pass filter signals and 4 high pass filter signals. Hence, the subbands are extracted successfully. Now, to extract the features of the input signal, click on the features button. The input features of the EEG signals are extracted. The final process is the NN classification process. Last but not the least, when the NN training button is selected, the input features are extracted and it is compared with the dataset signal features. Through this, NN training is completed. Hence, the NN training process is completed. The final process is the classification. By clicking on the classification button, it will classify the signals and give the output whether the patient is normal or abnormal. It compares the input EEG signal and ECG signal from the database and reveals the output. Hence, the person is displayed as normal. Thus, the sensitivity specificity and accuracy are displayed on the screen. It has been displayed as 95%. Likewise, any input signals can be classified according to this process. Thank you.